Peace, peace, peace. This is your boy Juice Wonder with another episode of Smoke and Jokes, where we discuss today's topics while indulging in the greatest of herbal essences. See, today's show was brought to you by ice cream cake. Come on, man. Who don't like some ice cream cake? All right. I wanted to talk to y'all about a brother. Hold on, bring him down here, by the name of George Jackson, right? He was an activist. He died in prison. They shot him saying he was trying to escape. But this happened a year after his brother, attempted to free apparently him and some other fellow activists and wind up getting killed along with a judge and all of that, right? So who was this man that somebody like one of our most influential artist of our time, 2pac Shakur, even made a song about him, right? Now, the song is called Soulja Story. It's on his first album. And because of this song, he came across a lot of conflict with white people. And to me personally, I feel like this is one of the reasons why they wanted him dead, because he was living out those teachings, right? He saw, you know, white men harassing black people. He shot them. Turns out to be police. He didn't do it because they were police, because an activist is not just against the police. It's against the oppression of all of them. You understand what I'm saying? It's not a selected thing where, like, because, you know, there's good police officers, so now all of a sudden you don't have to hold that same feeling. You understand what I'm saying? So I'm gonna play this track first, right? And then we're gonna get back into, you know, the brother himself. Let me bring this down real quick.
They cutting off welfare. They think crime is rising there. You got whites killing blacks, cops killing blacks, and blacks killing blacks. Shit just gonna get worse. Niggas gonna come soldiers, straight soldiers. All you wanted to be, a soldier, a soldier. All you wanted to be, a soldier like me. All you wanted to be, a soldier, a soldier. All you wanted to be, a soldier like me. All you wanted to be, a soldier, a soldier. All you wanted to be, a soldier, a soldier. All you wanted to be, a soldier, a soldier. All you wanted to be, a soldier like me. Cracked and took a part of a family tree. My mama's on this shit, my daddy's quitting. Mama's steady blaming me. Is it my fault just cause I'm a young black male? Cops sweating me as if my destiny is making crack sales. Only 15 and got problems. Cops on my tail, so I bail till I dodge them. They finally pulled me over and I laugh. Remember Rodney King and I blast on this punk ass. Now I got a murder case. You speak of heaven, punk? I never heard of the place. Wanted to come up fast, got a ooze and a black mask. Stuck in fucking tasks. Now who's the jackass? Keep my shit cop, cause the cops got a Glock too. What the fuck would you do? Drop him or let him drop you? I chose dropping the cop. I got me a Glock and a Glock for the niggas on my block. Mama tried to stab me, I moved out. Told a pound of weed, made G's, bought a new house. I'm only 17, I'm the new kid. Got me a group, bought them juice and a ooze thing. But all good things don't last. Task came fast and busted my black ass. Cooling in the pit where the goods got. Now my little brother wants to follow in my footsteps.
All you want to be, a soldier, a soldier. All you want to be, a soldier like me. All you want to be, a soldier, a soldier. All you want to be, a soldier.
sick of making it to an exit. Walking through the streets on the black tip, back with several cats, cause I'm on some paying back shit. Niggas don't wanna try me, bluffing, you'll get shot down. Now I'm king of the block, since my bigger brother's locked down. I'm hot now, so many punk police have got shot down. Other cops see me on the block and they jock now. That's what I call a kingpin. Tell my brother what he needs and some weed up to sing. Tell him just be ready, set. Pack your shit up quick, and when I hit, be prepared to jet. Niggas from the block, on the boat now. Every single one got a gun that'll smoke out. These pups about to get hit by the vest. I'm wearing double vests, so aim at my fucking chest. I'll be making straight dome calls. Touch the button on the wall, you'll be picking up your own balls. I can still hear my mother shout. Hit the pin, nigga. Break your bigger brother out. I got a message for the ward. I'm coming for your ass as fast as Flash Gordon. We get surrounded in the mezzo. Yes, yo, a crazy motherfucker making death calls. Just bring me my brother and we leave it. For every minute Jeep store, one of y'all leave. They brought my brother in a jiffy. I took a cop just in case things got tricky. And just as we was walking out, I caught a bullet in the head. The screams never left my mouth. My brother caught a bullet too. I think he gon' pull through. He deserved to. The fast life ain't everything they told ya. Never get much older. Following the tracks of a soldier.
A soldier, a soldier. All he wanted to be. A soldier. All he wanted to be. A soldier, a soldier.
All right. Now you can see the importance of the impact this man had on Tupac, right? I mean, you could hear him describing this man, right? I put up the clips of his ordeal. There's a thing called Black August, right? Now, in the Black August, it's about the race riots that was taking place in the California prison system, which resulted in, you know, like I said, a judge being killed, correction officers being killed, inmates being killed, one being George Jackson himself, you know, family being, you know, destroyed, you know, because of the Jackson family, you know, his younger brother, who was only 17 at the time, you know, wound up losing his life, you know, to this ordeal as well. So to show that, you know, racism destroys Black families. It divides us, you know, and I'm going to show that through this book. It's in reference to George Jackson because it's his book. His letters that he wrote while he was incarcerated, right? And so these letters describe, you know, the situations he was in, plus the mind state he was in as he addresses things that come across him, right? So this is just really the beginning. It's a real great book. I'm actually just playing the audio version because I don't want to hold y'all up with me doing it. There's actually online and on YouTube you could look, and it has the audio version of the book. Say, like, if you riding or whatever, you could just listen to this. But understand the mind state. Anybody who listens after a while will know my mind state. But if you don't, I'ma be doing breakdowns based on the letters and how I see it as, wow, this is me. You know what I'm saying? Now, I've done read this book, you know, back in the days. I was just fortunate enough to find it online. So what I'm going to do is try to do more of these, you know, things that I've read and, the influence they had on me, because I've came across all of this stuff young, understanding inside of myself what I was. Like, this is not something that you become. This is something you is. You understand what I'm saying? Like, the vanguard of this, this is just what we are. We the madmen, we the crazy niggas, the bugged out dudes, the ones that, you know, just won't conform. You understand what I'm saying? And it won't do that. So I'm gonna play this right here. Like I said, this is Soledad Brother out of the George Jackson book.
Soledad Brother, The Prison Letters of George Jackson. What is the Soledad Brothers case? Who is George Jackson? On January 13, 1969, 8 white prisoners and 7 blacks were skin searched for weapons and sent out to a special exercise yard in Soledad Prison, Salinas, California. Within minutes, a fight broke out in the yard. What happened next is a matter of controversy. Convict survivors of the incidents claim that a tower guard began to fire methodically at the black convicts without any warning. 4 shots were fired and 3 black convicts were killed. 1 white prisoner was wounded in the groin. Inmate survivors claim that the guard would not allow them to remove the injured convicts to the prison hospital for over 20 minutes, and that as a result, one of the black convicts, wounded in the leg, bled to death on the concrete floor. 3 days after the incident, the Monterey County Grand Jury made public its finding that the guard's action was justifiable homicide. Less than half an hour after this finding was announced on the prison radio, a white guard, not the guard who had fired the shots, was found beaten to death. All the convicts in the wing where the killing took place were put into isolation. 6 days later, 3 black convicts were accused of the murder. Fleeta Drumgo, John Clutchett, and George Jackson. According to their testimonies, they were accused not because there was any substantial evidence of their guilt, but because they had been previously identified as black militants by the prison authorities. 2 hearings were held in Monterey County with the accused men in chains and shackles. Their families were not present in the courtroom because no word of the charge had been allowed to leak out of the prison. All mail mentioning the case had been held up by the prison authorities. A 3rd hearing was about to take place when John Clutchett managed to smuggle a note to his mother. With the help of Huey P. Newton and a state senator, his mother contacted a lawyer. This was the beginning of what has become one of the most extensive legal defenses in American history. George Jackson is a living legend throughout the prison system. Every inmate that I've talked to, every convict who has been around the California prisons for any length of time, knows about George and has high regard for him. Even some of the white racist inmates have respect for him because they view him as a man who is totally straight. They know he is going to do exactly what he says he is going to do. They know George is a for real man. George has rejected even the possibility of getting out of prison because he refuses to violate his own integrity or the integrity of his fellow inmates. He refuses to compromise in any way to gain personal privilege. He has stood up and let himself be counted regardless of personal cost. George is a true revolutionary.
Okay. Now, as you listen to that, right, you understand that the final impact, because they give you the conclusion in the beginning, right? You know, because most people know his life, right? So I'm going to get into how we got to that. You know, how, you know, a robbery for $70 gets nobody hurt, nobody killed, right? How this robbery gets him, hold on, how this robbery gets him, like, basically 10 years, because that's how much time he did before they killed him. But he was serving a one-to-life bid under the impression that he was gonna be home, you know, after a year, you know, but because of his style of person, they wasn't working with him. You know, basically, that's what the whole thing was, is like he had an influence. And now here it is, he wasn't the jailhouse rat. He wasn't one of them dudes who had the power but was really fronting and dropping kites and all that. And I've seen it, even in, you know, New York jails, you know, just on the county, you know, I've seen it. And I can give you the stories of dudes dropping kites and, you know, a whole bunch of fucked up shit happening behind it. So, yeah, these gangsters, you know, once they in there, it's yes, sir, this, sir. And so, you know, being a type of guy that's against the system, I guess at that time it was easier to find counterparts. You know what I'm saying? Because in today's time, fighting the system is, who's controlling the TV? Who's controlling, you know, what share and, you know, silly shit. That's not oppression. You know, how you got there is the oppression. So to have the people that's willing to address that and not kiss down to the true enemy, and then even get other people to take that stand, is the strength. It was so strong of him. Out of his 10 years, he did 7 of it in solitary confinement, where the average man would break. I did 2 years and some change in a supermax, and, you know, the handcuffing to go to the shower and all of that. Like it's the same thing. The average man would break. They don't, and, you know, or they would, you know, explode or implode, but only on their own. Where, you know, I was doing my best to avoid that, you know, because I was labeled SRG threat member. So it was like, you got SRG, basically like members of gangs, right? And then you got a threat member, which is somebody who can get those members to do things. So, you know, they'll do anything to get you to, you know, to break you. You understand what I'm saying? Me, like, the only reason why I even made it out the program was due to the fact that I had, like, I think like 2 months left to go home. And, you know, I knew that they harassed you out on the street. I was in Connecticut at this time. So I knew that they would harass you on the street. And that was basically the reason why, you know, I completed it. But I had to complete it staying away from these fucking idiots inside here. You know, and once you stay away from people, they got it in their head that you're afraid of them. So then that led to a whole bunch of other stuff where it looks like I'm an indulger of self-hate. And it's not that. It's like you approaching something and I have to address it with no matter who it is. It just so happens that if I can be, you know, standoffish about certain things with, you know, the white man, I can do that with you, meaning that I can just say separation is peace for right now. If you pursue it, then I have to defend it. But there's times when you walk away from it in the white world, right? So then you could walk away from it in the black world. And that's what I had to do in order for me to walk away from many a situation. It's just like, you know what? Stop extending your black love but to everybody, because you had to realize that everybody doesn't deal with black love. A lot of people are dealing with, you know, the bibs, you know, blacks and blackface. You understand what I'm saying? And they dealing with confusion. You know, they just, you know, they confused. They don't know. Cooning has been such a thing that now, like, dudes are confused. They don't even know what cooning is no more. So they'll support something up until everybody go, wait a minute, that's a coon. And when you calling it out, it's, oh, you a hater, this, that, and the third. You see what I'm saying? So they confused. They don't know where they at in that. But like I said, George Jackson was a very powerful mind right here in the United States. He was respected and revered. He died in prison trying to live, and they killed him. They say that, you know, he attempted an escape where he tried to murder police officers, and, you know, that's why you got the thing of the San Quentin Six, where people wound up getting killed, and these people were on trial behind that. So, I mean, but there's so many levels and facets to this that, like I said, I'm going to stick to it as far as the book. But then inside of that, I'll add, you know, personal information, because a lot of these people, you know, like Angela Davis, she has her own books. And so it'd be a lot to work off of. And this series where I'm going to be calling it, you know, my politics as usual. We're still all under the, you know, smoking jokes. It's just that this is black politics. And as black people, we need to understand that we are political. And so 90% out of the time, you know, outside of rape, you know, molestation, of course, and we would have to set some standards of even murder, right? Even murder of a fellow black man should be considered criminal. You understand what I'm saying? I mean, in our community, the other things we don't hold control of, so that's when, you know, how we maneuver should be respected. I'll get into all of that later. I just wanted to say that. And oh, by the way, if you know, if you notice, you don't see me in any logos. I've been revolutionary my whole life. You know what I'm saying? If you look outside of, you know, my Yankee cap, and I got to get over that. If you see, I don't have, you know, logos. I've never owned a pair of Timberland construction Timbs in my life. I've owned Timberlands. I just never owned construction Timbs. I don't fit into the Hennessy thing. And, you know, I'm one of the dead ass originators, but I'm not a facts, you know, kind of guy. You know, I'm probably in it for a brief moment, but like I said, I don't follow that. So the reason why I'm saying that is because I do my own thing. I'm in the mix of trying to make my own logos and make my own. You know, I ain't trying to start no clothing company. I ain't no fashion designer. I wind up doing some Kanye West type shit too. So, you know, I ain't got nobody to say I'm a genius to help me hustle y'all for a quick moment. So I'm not a fashion designer. I'm just somebody who refuses to support my oppressors, right? So, you know, with that, like I said, and that's because of, it goes back to when I was younger. I remember the first company that I heard about racism was Troop. Now, me, myself, I was a a quiet LL fan. You know what I'm saying? Because me and my boy D used to go at it over Shannon and LL. So I was a quiet LL fan. I really didn't want to say, you know, he was official like that. So when I found out that he was one of the people supported by Troop, you know, that, you know, especially when I found out what Troop was. And then from that, I learned about Reebok and the apartheid. So after that, I never wore Reebok. So like after a while, I just started gradually falling away from that. But then I also noticed when you dealing with people, that's all they care about is the label. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, with that, like I said, if you got a black company and you got a label, you want some publicity, holler at me. I'll put it up in the background here. You know, you ain't got to send me no clothes or nothing like that. Just send me the company name and I'll have some advertisement going on for you. All right? Like I said, this is your boy Juice Wonder. This is Smoking Jokes, Politics as Usual. And this was about my nigga George Jackson and my nigga 2pac Shakur. And this is going to be going on. I just wanted y'all to know a connection and a history. Peace.